One of the most important skills for a film composer to possess is to write memorable musical themes for characters, objects, or locations. When these themes return throughout a film or film series, the musical theme is called a leitmotif, and there are two videos on this channel that explain the leitmotif in more detail. There will be a link to these at the end of this video. The most important thing about a successful leitmotif is that it will change, adapt, and develop with the character, object, or location that it represents. In this video, we will be looking at how John Williams adapts the Imperial March in the Star Wars series in line with Darth Vader's story. Before we do this, we should briefly summarise what exactly Darth Vader's story is. For those of you who haven't seen the Star Wars films and may wish to in the future, this video contains major spoilers, you have been warned. Darth Vader is introduced as a child by the name of Anakin Skywalker, living with his slave mother on the planet Tatooine. Anakin was discovered by the Jedi Qui-Gon Jinn, who, after sensing that Anakin had a high connection to the Force, convinced the Jedi Council to let Obi-Wan Kenobi train Anakin as a Jedi. Over the next decade, Anakin rose to become one of the strongest Jedi in galactic history. While he was both caring and compassionate, his fear of loss was ultimately the catalyst for his downfall. Anakin eventually succumbed to the temptations of the dark side of the Force, believing that the Sith, the evil version of the Jedi, had the power to save the life of his secret wife Padme Amidala. Anakin's new master christened him Darth Vader, and the descent to evil was complete. Vader's former master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, seemingly defeated him in a lightsaber duel that left Vader badly burnt and mutilated. As a consequence of his defeat, he was rebuilt as a cyborg and encased in a life-sustaining suit of armour, which we now know as the famous Black Darth Vader suit. Years later, a confrontation with his son, the aspiring Jedi Luke Skywalker, awoke the compassion within Vader, causing him to kill the evil Emperor Palpatine, his current master, in order to save Luke from certain death. By killing his master, however, Vader sustained critical damage to his armour, making death inevitable. Resigned to his fate, his dying wish was to see his son with his own eyes for the first and final time, and his final act was to remove his helmet before passing away. Vader's story is a tragic one of a descent into evil and ultimately redemption, and John Williams accompanied his story with one of the most famous musical leitmotifs in cinematic history, the Imperial March. Let's begin the story of the Imperial March by rewinding to the beginning of the Darth Vader story and Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Of course, Anakin at this stage is not evil, he's an innocent young boy trying to make his way through a difficult childhood. John Williams responds to this by giving us the slightest hint that his future may be clouded, and for those who listen closely, some of the familiar harmonies of the Imperial March can be heard at the end of Anakin's theme. There is one other moment in Episode 1 where the Imperial March is heard. As Jedi Master Yoda and Obi-Wan Kenobi discuss the training of Anakin to be a Jedi, we hear a very subtle two-bar excerpt of the Imperial March's main melody. This coincides with Yoda showing his concern that Anakin may have a dangerous future ahead of him.
The Chosen One, the boy may be. Nevertheless, grave danger I fear in his training.
Master Yoda, I gave Qui-Gon my word.
In Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, Anakin begins to show some of the petulance and anger that will eventually lead him to fall to the dark side of the Force. Whilst talking to Padme about murdering a group of sand people in revenge for his mother's death, Anakin becomes angrier and angrier. This is accompanied first by another leitmotif, that of the evil Emperor Palpatine, but then by a stronger rendition of the Imperial March. It still doesn't quite reach the full power that we will see later in the story, but the foreshadowing of Anakin's future is now clear for all to see and hear.
I hate them!
In Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, Anakin completes his transition to Darth Vader. In a particularly poignant scene, Williams combines several leitmotifs from the film series. As Padme's funeral takes place, with her having died in childbirth, we hear the death leitmotif in the strings. This then transitions to the Force leitmotif as the scene shifts to an Imperial Star Destroyer and Darth Vader. As the death theme is reintroduced, we also hear the Imperial March prominently. As the Imperial March enters, we also hear, for one of the first times, the signature breathing sound from within Vader's suit. Notice how the Imperial March is sinister, yet still somehow withdrawn or apprehensive. By the end of Episode 3, we've still not yet heard a full statement of the Imperial March directly linked to Darth Vader. Interestingly, John Williams hadn't composed the Imperial March when the original 1977 film, Episode 4, A New Hope, was released. Instead, we hear this less dramatic brass motif in comparison to the Imperial March. The next film in the chronological story of Darth Vader was Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back, and it's here where the Imperial March really shines. The leitmotif in this film is so explicitly linked to Darth Vader's character that it is invariably heard whenever the character is on screen. We hear several variations of it, most notably the full militaristic rendition when we see the Imperial Starfleet at the start of the film.
It's a good bet the Empire knows we're here.
We better start the evacuation.
We also hear a slower, more menacing variation as he enters a scene. In terms of the order in which the films were released, this was the first time cinema audiences heard the Imperial March. So it's perhaps unsurprising that Williams showed off his new leitmotif in all its glory throughout the film. So far, we've seen how Williams has hinted at Anakin's future by weaving subtle references to the Imperial March into the first films in the saga. We then saw how the Imperial March was used in full force in The Empire Strikes Back to represent the evil persona of Darth Vader. However, it is arguably the sixth film in the series that really highlights the genius of Williams when it comes to adapting a musical theme to fit a narrative. At the end of Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, Darth Vader is dying after sacrificing himself to save Luke's life. As father and son are together for the last time and Vader completes his story of redemption, Williams does something very interesting and very effective with the Imperial March. One possibility here would have been for him to remove the Imperial March altogether. After all, the evil character of Vader has effectively already died, replaced briefly with the redeemed Anakin Skywalker. Instead, though, Williams transforms the Imperial March into something utterly tragic, tender, and heartbreaking. As Vader is dying, we hear several iterations of the Imperial March melody, but it sounds like nothing we've heard in the films so far. First, we hear the melody on delicate high strings. Then we hear it on the ethereal soft sound of the flute.
No. Go, my son. Leave me.
No. You're coming with me. I'll not leave you here. I've got to save you.
You already have.
Next, the melody is heard on the heroic French horn.
Tell your sister you were right.
Finally, in a remarkable use of instrumentation and leitmotific adaptation, the Imperial March is heard on possibly the softest sounding instrument at Williams' disposal, a solo harp. So there we have it. The musical theme or leitmotif for one of the most menacing characters in cinematic history has made an epic journey through the film series, just like the character it represents. From the subtle hints in episode 1, The Phantom Menace, when Anakin was a boy, to the rousing, terrifying militaristic rendition in episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back, to the heartbreaking tenderness of the solo harp in episode 6, Return of the Jedi, John Williams has shown how effective musical themes can be when they are adapted in line with the story. The Imperial March appears in the newest trilogy too, whenever Vader is mentioned, but that's perhaps a video for another day. For now, sit back and enjoy Williams' magnificent Imperial March one last time. Thanks for watching.